Let us see an expression for the radius of curvature for a polar curve. So the formula for radius of curvature, when the curve is given in the polar form, that means the polar curve is of the form r is equal to f of theta. So this is a curve in the polar coordinates. Then how do we find radius of curvature? We can find by using this formula. Where r1 is dr by d theta, r2 is d square r by d theta square, then we have an expression for radius of curvature for a pedal curve, which is given by this formula. Let us take one example for the radius of curvature in polar form. Here in this question they are asking, show that the radius of curvature of the curve r to the power n is equal to a to the power n into cos n theta, where is inversely as r to the power n minus 1. Inversely means we need to prove rho is proportional to 1 divided by r to the power n minus 1. So this means inversely, that's why we have 1 divided by, that means inversely proportional. So this is what we need to prove. That is, if you remove this proportionality, we get a constant here, proportionality constant. This is what we need to prove. Rho is equal to some constant times 1 divided by r to the power n minus 1. Let us take the given curve. Taking log on both sides. Let us take log on both sides. Yes, we have applied log on both sides. Now use the property of logarithm. This becomes n log r, and this is of the form log of mn, log of m into n, which becomes log of m plus log of n plus log n theta. So further, when we apply the logarithmic property to this, this n will come as a multiply. Now let us differentiate with respect to theta both sides. N is a constant, we keep as it is. We differentiate log r. It becomes 1 by r into dr by d theta. N log a is a constant, so therefore its derivative will go to 0. Here we have two functions. Log is one function. Actually, we have three functions here. Log is one function, cos is another function, and n theta is one more function. So to differentiate this, we need to use the chain rule. Differentiation of log gives, that is, differentiation of log with respect to cos n theta gives 1 divided by cos n theta into differentiation of cos n theta. Differentiation of cos is minus sin n theta into differentiation of n theta, where n is a constant and differentiation of theta with respect to theta will be 1. N as it is, differentiation of theta will be 1. So when we rewrite this equation, we get this. Here we can see this n and this n we can cancel by dividing both sides by n. We have this. We all know sin n theta by cos n theta gives tan n theta. Since we want r1 in the formula, r1, that is dr by d theta we want, cross multiply this r to the other side, it becomes dr by d theta is equal to minus r tan n theta. Let us call this as r1, which we require in the formula to find radius of curvature for the polar curve. Differentiating again with respect to theta, let us differentiate this with respect to theta again now, because we want r2 also. Differentiation of r1 gives r2 minus as it is outside. To differentiate this, we need to apply the product rule. First function as it is, differentiation of tan gives secant square n theta into differentiation of n theta gives n. That is, we are using product rule for that. To differentiate tan n theta, we are using the chain rule. So differentiation of n theta is n. Now plus differentiation of first function into second function as it is. So we have done a product rule differentiation to this. This can be rewritten as n r secant square n theta multiplied by minus sign. Here also we'll multiply minus sign now. Minus r1 tan n theta. Now let us use the formula for rho, that is radius of curvature in polar form. Now we substitute the values of r1 and r2, wherever r1 is there its value, and then r2 value will put. We have kept r square as it is, to the power 3 by 2 as it is. Let us substitute the value of r1 here. R1 is minus r tan n theta whole square, we read right as it is, the whole square, divided by r square plus 2 times r1 square. Here the value will substitute minus r into r2 value here. Yes, we have substituted. Now let us simplify it further. When we separate the squares for all, what we get is minus becomes plus. This is r square into tan square. Here also we will apply the square to all, which gives this, and we multiply with this minus r inside, minus into minus, plus n r square secant square n theta. Then when we multiply minus r with the second term, minus into minus, plus r into r1 tan n theta. In the next step, we can observe here r square is common. When we take r square outside, what we get inside the brackets? 1 plus tan square and theta. Also, we need to observe that we should write r square common under this power. We cannot take outside the power and write r square outside the power. Now let us simplify the denominator. We have written till here as it is. Till here as it is. Let us substitute the value of r1 here. R1 tan n theta. Now this becomes plus into minus minus r square tan square n theta, and in the numerator we have separated the power 3 by 2 for this, and we will separate for this. And before that, we know 1 plus tan square is secant square n theta, and we have splitted the powers for both. Let us rewrite the denominator now. As I said, this is minus r square tan square n theta, which we have written here. Now we can observe in the denominator r square is common, and in the numerator this by 2 and this square gets cancelled. We get r cube here, and here as well this by 2 and this square gets cancelled. Secant cube n theta remains in the numerator. I have taken the same step from the previous slide. Let us see what are the changes we have. Now this becomes r cube, this becomes secant tan theta whole cube. We have written this r square as it is, and in the denominator you can observe this is plus 2 times r square n square r square 2 r square tan square n theta minus r square tan square n theta. This is 2 times, this is 1 time. So 2 minus 1 gives 1 time. 1 time r square into tan square n theta. We have just subtracted these two and we have written here. Then what is left out? This term is left out. Let us write down this now. The numerator we have written in this way, and in the denominator r square is common. Let us take r square outside. What we have is, here we get 1 tan square n theta n into secant square n theta. Here we know 1 plus tan square n theta is secant square n theta. Yes, for that first we have cancelled this square r square with this r square. Only r remains in the numerator, which we have written here. As I said, we can write 1 plus tan square n theta as secant square n theta. Then secant square n theta can be taken out as a common in the denominator. Yes, we have taken secant square n theta common, and secant square with the secant square gets cancelled. 1 secant n theta remains in the numerator. Now let us see what will be secant n theta. Yes, we have separated out secant n theta. We have from the given equation r to the power n is equal to a to the power n into cos n theta. Let us bring secant n theta in picture in this expression. For that we need to take the reciprocal on both sides. If we take the reciprocal, we get 1 by r to the power n. Reciprocal of this will be 1 divided by a to the power n into 1 divided by cos n theta. We all know the reciprocal of cos n theta is secant n theta. Therefore, secant n theta is equal to, we have written secant n theta here. Then we cross multiply this a to the power n to the other side. So secant n theta gives a to the power n divided by r to the power n. So this is what we can replace in the place of secant n theta in this equation. Let us replace it now. Yes, we have replaced the value of secant n theta here in the place of secant n theta. Now you can see one time r gets cancelled with one time r here. So that r to the power n minus 1 remains here in the denominator. So after cancellation 1 r, what remains is here 1 divided by r to the power n minus 1. This means that rho is equal to constant into 1 divided by r to the power n minus 1. This we have written as a constant. This equation means that rho is proportional to 1 divided by r to the power n minus 1. That means rho is proportional to, sorry, rho is inversely proportional to r to the power n minus 1, because we have 1 divided by, so we can say rho is inversely proportional to r to the power n minus 1.